Good morning, everyone. Good afternoon. Good evening, wherever you're watching from at this hour. Today is the 12th of October, 2021. And this morning, on this video, we're just going to do like a follow-up or like a part two of the last video we did. It's going to be more of analyzing. I'm just going to analyze the chart because the last video I did, if you haven't watched that video, I would advise you go and watch that video. It will really assist you in moving forward as a forex trader, so you know what pattern you are looking for. Whenever you spot a pattern in the chart, you know, okay, this pattern is what is building up, and then it will give you that patient mentality and that patient mindset to wait for a pattern to build up fully before executing any trade. That's the reason why I'm doing this. That's the reason why I'm analyzing this. So the last video will be, I remember I ran out of time actually, and I wasn't able to analyze the other chart that we're supposed to analyze. And I promised that I was going to do it the next day, but I was very busy. I traveled and just came back 2 days ago on Sunday. Yeah, I came back to the office on Monday. So I got back and I saw a lot of emails who were saying, you said you were supposed to do the video the next day. That was true. I actually promised I was going to do the video the next day, but I was absolutely busy and I had to travel and all that. So I'm making this video today. Now it's just going to be like a part two of the video we did, but it's going to be another chart that we analyze. If you haven't watched that video, the last one we did, I would advise you go and watch it because it's going to assist you as a forex trader, so that when you're looking at any chart, you know what you're looking for. Let's assume a bullish engulfing pattern, a bearish engulfing pattern, or a piercing line, or a doji is building, and then you have that awareness to say, okay, let me wait and see what is building up here. Even if you are, even if on a daily time frame, let's assume you are even like you are working a 9-to-5 job, and then you come back home and you are on like a scalping level, and you are on, let's say, on 30 minutes, 15 minutes, 5 minutes of time frame, then you are able to know, okay, if a bullish engulfing pattern is building, okay, let me wait for the 3 candle or 4 candle to build up to confirm that this is a bullish engulfing pattern, or is a piercing line. Let me wait for 1 and 2 to find out if there's a piercing line or is a doji, and all that. You wait, then once it builds up and is confirmed, then you can execute a trade so that you can make profit. Even if you're making 2%, even if you're making 5%, even if you're making 1% of every day, you see yourself, you will be moving forward, you'll be growing as a forex trader, and that will now build your confidence, and that will now build your mentality in the market. And now you now see yourself being consistent, and you can eliminate a greed from your mind and eliminate this thinking of robotic signal that doesn't work. I've told you guys, it doesn't work, it has never worked, and it's never going to work. So it's a waste of time, it's a waste of energy, is a waste of money. So it doesn't work, it doesn't work. What works in the market is you being able to understand what moves the market, that the mentality, the psychology that moves the market, that the psychology that links all traders together. Once you are able to get these little pieces together, you see yourself moving forward as a forex trader. And you have to know, are patient with the market. You need to be patient with the market. You need to embark on learning. You need to embark on study and building your mindset, eliminating this get money quick, get rich quickly mindset from yourself. Because you see, there are some natural things that are attached to forex trading that a lot of people don't know. And once you bypass those processes, you see yourself, you definitely struggle. Like one of the quotes I love that Mie Kam, he said, a man who attempts to fight the iron logic of nature thereby fights the principle he must stand for his life. Fighting against nature is bringing about one's own destruction. So if you are fighting against some of the natural things and some of the natural process of forex trading, you are bringing about your own destruction. And that's why you see a lot of people coming and then they go out and coming in with that hyper and that agility move to come and make the money from the market without following the proper due process. And then they go in and They come back in pains because why? You are bypassing the natural principle of forestry, which is coming in with a mindset of let me go and be consistent in the market. And then once you are not consistent in the market, you see now you become profitable because like I always say, that's one of my slogans, don't confuse profitability in the market with consistency. They are two different things. You can be profitable today and then you are out of the market. But once you are not consistent in the market, you see yourself, you will not be profitable in the long run. You will build your portfolio gradually, step by step. You can eliminate greed from your mindset and focus on what you're doing. Even if you are making $1 in a day, you're making $2, $5, $10 in a day, you know you are building, you are not overexposing your account, you are not you don't allow greed to creep into your thinking, which is very dangerous. Those are the steps and the foundation that someone coming into forestry need to build on. Not just looking at these people are buying cars, they are renting cars to entice you and all that, and then you think forest trading is all about the fancy life. Not about the fancy life. You see the likes of Warren Buffett. Now he always started using iPhone of recent or a computer of recent. So you see these people have been there. It's not about someone that's driving all around the country, the city. What then do you not have to analyze the chart? Because what we're going to do now, we're just going to dive in and analyze the chart that I was supposed to analyze last week. We analyze it now so that you know the pattern that I spotted and what gave me my bias to open or execute a trade on this particular pick, so that whenever you are on your own and you are on the chart, you see something like that, you remember, you can easily revert back to what I have spoken about and say, okay, I think this was going to build up here now, and you see yourself becoming profitable. Like what someone said, he sent me an email. He said, he's talking about me now. He said, sir, even if you not decide to even develop any software and say this is your software, robotic software that can assist you in knowing what to pick, he said people will easily believe you because why? They have seen your chart. Because what we do here, you can go, you visit our Instagram page, visit our Facebook, and even our YouTube channel, you see that what we do is I don't analyze the chart that has already happened or what's maybe a market that played out, and then I'm now analyzing and trying to make sense of what happened. No, it has already happened. It's gone. If I was not in the peak, then it's gone. That is what we do, is I analyze the chart and say, this is what I said. I will say, this is what is going to happen. This is what I think. This is my bias. And this is why I am I'm having this bias to open a trade on this particular pick. And then at the end of the day, the end of the week, we come back and then we see that, wow, everything this guy said actually played out that way. That's how to know a good forest trader. That's how to know intelligent forest trader. So you can build and build a good portfolio for yourself and everyone, kid. Was not whatnot. So this morning I was just going to dive in. I think I've been talking too much and I said I wasn't going to do. So we're just going to analyze the chart. The chart was posted. Let me share the screen first. Screen what now? Screen. You're on screen four. I hope you can see this. This is the chart that was. Let me just select this thing. I'd like to zoom in this thing because am I going to put this next? Let me just put it here. I hope you can see me. So this was the chart. This is the peak we are going to be analyzing today. I'm just going to make sure it's pre. This is the chart that was sent out. Let's first of all go to our Instagram page, because like I said, we post it on Instagram so that it's there for you to, before it happens. It's not like we're shy, we're scared of something. No, we post it on Instagram, and then at the end of the week we come back and then you see that what we actually analyzed came to fruition. What's this one? Okay, this is our Instagram page. As you all know, please follow us on Instagram. follow us on YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook as well, like and share. So this was our, let me look for when it was posted. I think it was posted, yeah, there's the chart. You can see it was posted on the 27th of September 2021. That's the date here. You can see it here on just where my mouse cursor is now. It was posted on the 27th of September 2021. My bias was very clear. It was detailed. You can go back to our YouTube channel and Facebook and Instagram. You see the chart there. It's still there. This was before it happened. So the reason why I'm coming now to this image, because I can't zoom in and zoom out on Instagram. So this is the chart anyway, but this is not the live market. So if you can see on my left hand side where my mouse cursor is now, you see the when it was published on tradingview.com, September 27th, 2021, at about 6:37 UTC. It was Australian dollar, US dollar. And what was my bias? Because someone said, "Say, how come you are able to know, okay, this is what's going to play out, and then you detail it, and it comes out like that?" It's not a guesswork. It's not because I'm too knowledgeable in the market. It's just because I'm able to put in the hard work. I'm able to study and analyze what has happened, do a proper backtesting. So what we said on this chart was this. First of all, where I said I spotted a tweezer top invalidation. This is why the tweezer top came on board. So I spotted the tweezer top invalidation at this level and we saw a pullback. So what my key area was, at this level. This was now where my key area is. And this, like last video I showed you, I said, like this one was also, like an outlier, but it wasn't that pronounced. But then it's still validated, this outlier. But this area was my key area of interest, where I wrote a key area of interest was this level. And then the market was trading at this level then. So we spotted the tweezer top invalidation at this level that signaled the 4, and this place acted as support. This place was acting as support in the past, and then in between this place support, that's why I said, maybe I would have to buy a pen, this thing, so I can be writing. Sometimes I just want to use my pen to analyze. So this was acting as support. We saw a bounce. So now, what gave me my bias? We saw a continuation downside. We saw a bounce one. We saw a continuation downside. We saw a bounce again, upside, sorry. We saw a bounce. We saw a continuation, and it broke out from this level. This level that has acted as a resistance in the past. This place was acting as a resistance. This place was acting as support. Mind you, this is this is not the live market now. We're going to go into the live market now to see what actually played out. So I'm just trying to analyze. This was what we posted on our Instagram page. This the market I analyzed, and I told you that this is what I expected to happen. I expected the continuation downside to bounce again. Yes, since we have already broken out from this resistance in the past, resistance now at this level, and then we spotted a tweezer top invalidation at this level. So I expected a fall to also respect this level here, which it did. Then there was a continuation again to respect this level. So what I said is, I expected a fall downside at this level, then a continuation, a pullback to test at this level again to give him a momentum, because my bias was now we are going to break out from this support zone. So my bias was that we're going to break out from this support zone. And then what I said was that we're going to see a continuation downside to test at this level, which I was expecting. Then I anticipated that we're going to see a little pullback to also test at this level, because this area was my key level. And then we're going to see a force straight up to go eat our TP at this level. So if we go now to the live market now to see what actually played out, let me this the market now this the market was posted when on the 27th, right? Was it? Yeah, 27th of September. So which was at this level. If you see now my mask also is now, you see, look at it down there, you see on the 27th of the, let me just go a little bit. 27. So the market, the scan was posted while the market was still at this level. It's almost 2 o'clock. So I expected what I said, I expected a continuation. And mind you, our order, like I said last time, our order was a pending order. So what I expected was, I expected a retest at this level to activate our entry. So what we actually saw was this. Let me just zoom out. So we, is this one? So I said we expected the continuation downside and then a little pullback to test at this level, then a fall. So if you see now, this is not a guesswork, like I always say. The market played out exactly and how I expected it to. So what we actually saw now, we saw the market was trading at this level, so continuation, a pullback to activate our entry. I remember when our entry got activated at this level, I think, yeah, it was our entry got activated at 0.73, yeah, at this level, 0.73000. That was what where our position got activated. So our position got activated. So we now saw a continuation, a little pullback then. Then look at what now happened. So we saw a fall to go respect this level that I said we are expecting at this level, as you can see. Then we now saw a pullback to this level, which is now at this level here. So let's go again. We saw a continuation downside. And then we now saw a pullback to respect this level here, which we said, yes. Then I said, we're going to see a little pullback to go test again at this level, which we now saw with this bearish candle here. What is this one? At this level here, which I said, we're supposed to see a pullback at this level of 0.72741. Then I expected the continuation downside to go hit our TP. And now look at where it gets interesting here. Just say, immediately our TP got activated here. You can see, immediately we got activated and got out of the market, we saw a rejection now. For the past, that was our TP got activated on the 29th of September 2021. We opened the market on the 27th of September 2021, and we got out of the market on the 29th of September 2021. And now see, immediately we got out of the market at this level. Now someone said, is it that you knew that this thing is going to have a rejection at this level? It's because I was able to do my back testing down to, and what I normally do, I like to do, that's why you see whenever I make some comment on the chart, I always say on the daily time frame. You see, Twitter top invalidated on a daily time, which you can see here on, I will just mark it, because why I like to do my analyze the chart on a daily time frame, so I can have a better understanding of what actually played out today, have a better understanding of what actually played out the next day. So it's not like 1 hour, 1 hour. So whenever I actively, I analyze my chart on a daily time frame, then I can go back now on the 1 hour time frame and then draw my some other trend line to it, horizontal line to it, so that I can know what I'm looking for. So just imagine, we saw now immediately we got a continuation downside, like I said, and then we saw a little pullback to test at this level again, which was this candle. Let me zoom in so you can see if it's it. So we saw again, test at this level. This place now, it was struggling at this level. Then immediately we saw a fall down to this level now. And then immediately, when was that? I think it was last week. I opened another trade on this. It was a buy position. The trade, I'm just looking at the trade now. We're almost hitting TP now on this same picking. Maybe we got out of the market. I allowed a time of which I was expecting. We saw this thing now. It was acting as a doji now. It was acting as the inverted hammer. This one was a doji hammer. You see three. This one built up a doji hammer, and this candle here invalidated it. And this one builds up again. And then we saw now a continuation down upside, build up a doji here, and then invalidated here again. We saw a little farm down here. So that was where I went into the market. And I spotted here a piercing line here again that signaled that, wow, we are having a continuation. So immediately I spotted a piercing line, saw a continuation, and then we saw a little pullback. And then now we now saw a continuation. So if you even draw your trend line, at this level now, you see now, are we done with this trend? Are we done with this trend now? Are you sure this trend is going to touch base on this level? Now, if we saw now what I'm expecting now, you see it has tested this level. I expect, let me see if there's any, yeah, there's a relevance on this level here, that it has tested in the past. What's this now? If you see this level now becomes another pivotal area, this 0.7387. to it becomes another pivotal area. What I'm expecting now is this. I'm expecting a little struggle at this level to go maybe touch again and then have a little pullback, touch again, pullback to break out to come hit this level. But that's not my target. My target is almost at it. We are almost at, so I'm going to watch another pattern builds up. If another pattern builds up here, then we can take another trade to go maybe touch base again at this highs that we had before, and then pending if there's no fundamental that might creep in at any time. So this was the market that we analyzed the last time that I said I was going to analyze. So if you see what I said my bias was a short position below 0.7316 is cause for a further downtrend, with target at 0.71790, which we got activated here, 0.717. If you can see my mask also, it an extension. So we made our TP got locked here. Then, but we're still expecting maybe we have the momentum to go build take profit too. But our TP was already locked here. So once our rejection, we got out of the market. Our market position was closed. So if you see what I detail my chart and I know what I'm looking for in the market. So now if you spot a pattern builds up in on any trade, if you can now see what one thing I always advise people, if you are able to draw your support, your resistance, make a lot of notes, make a lot of trend lines so that you are sure of what you are entering into. Someone said, sir, you draw a lot of trend. Yeah, that because that's the reason why you're still seeing that immediately go to might take profit with sauna a rejection. This is not a guesswork, this is not a work of the robotic signal. No, this is a proper, when you do your proper due diligence in the market using your squeezer top to spot a pattern. This was what when it immediately the Twitter top got invalidated at this level here. Then we saw a fall continuation again. Then we saw a fall, a pullback. So it was respecting this level as resistance, this level as resistance. So my bias was, since we have tested this place three times, then we saw a breakout. Now we tested it again, and then we saw a pullback, then we tested it again. And what I expected was, immediately we tested this level, I was expecting the market to come to retest at this level again. right? That's why I drew my trainer to test at this level again and then go back here to build up a momentum to break through, because I was expecting a breakout from this key area of interest. So this is the market I said I was going to analyze for you guys. There's this other, the one we sent out yesterday. We're still going to come back maybe during the end of the week. This is the chart we sent out yesterday. I'm not sure if I have the you can go to our Instagram page. You'll see them there. This is the chart that was posted. You can see the date 23 hours ago. It was posted yesterday, the 11th of October. So by the end of this week now, what's it called? At the end of the week, you see we'll come back and then we'll also analyze. You see that what I actually said came played out just like that. And one thing I always do, like I said, whatever we're doing in the market is based on probability, is based on majority of the decision we're taking in the market is based on probability. The reason why my probability might be stronger than yours is because I'm able to do a lot of back testing and have patience with the market. So that's why I always I put a scenario one. This is what I expect. This is my strong bias. But then I'm still open for any news that can cripple my analysis, and then we'll see a pullback and maybe a reversal of my analysis. That's why you see I know when to get out of the market. I know when to spot my stop loss and all that. I know people say stop loss. What's it called again? Risk management and all that. And then you spot you're able to put your stop loss. And then I told you guys last time, you will be surprised that where you are even putting your stop loss is not even your stop loss. Your entry is not even your entry. You're just gambling and maybe using the Fibonacci retrenchment to draw your day. And then you set your stop loss and risk roll. And at the end of the day, if you lose this trade, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, your account is gone. So there's some things that a lot of traders need to put into consideration. Like I said, once in a while I will come out and then we'll analyze. I'll show you, like there was one time I used my Fibonacci retrenchment to open a trade. The video is still on our YouTube. You can go and check it on how I use my Fibonacci. That will also assist you as a trader, so you know when to put your entry and your stop loss. So that will be all for now. I'll see you again when I see you. I have a meeting right now, so I have to go. So have a lovely, lovely, lovely day. Today's Tuesday, and I hope our week will be profitable. I'll see you when I see you. Bye bye for now.